Hi, I'm Sharon Bale. Welcome to my YouTube channel and welcome to my theory tuition series where I'll lead you step by step through the ABRSM theory grades. We're working our way through grade one music theory, and so you will need your ABRSM music theory in practice workbook for grade one. You will also need some PDF information sheets that I've made available to you. If you visit my website, sharonbale.com, you'll find some free PDF information sheets. They're available in US letter or A4 to accompany each step of this series. There's also a page which links to my YouTube video tutorials. And you can also access information about the books I have available. I have a book, How to Take Your ABRSM Music Theory Exam, and it's full of tips and techniques of how to make the best use of this exam experience, which is what we are working towards in working through these booklets. And so we're now on to the subject of accidentals. So you will need to access the download, and you'll need to find section J. You will also need to find section K, the next page too. Let's turn in our work booklet. And so now we're on to page 14, which is entitled Accidentals. So I'll just write a letter J there, so we know that that's the sheet that you will be referring to. You will need a pencil and an eraser for this. So before we start talking about sharps, flats and natural signs, we just need to pop ahead to sheet K and we just need to think about tones and semitones for a moment. Regardless of whether you play the piano or not, I strongly recommend that you just get used to sketching out for yourself a piano keyboard. There's always a piece of scrap paper available in the exam, and whilst you're working through your booklet, I do suggest you have a piece of scrap paper, because it's so much easier to visualise these steps on a piano keyboard than just trying to hold it in your head. In its simplest form, a semitone is the absolute next door note on a piano, so whether it's a black note or a white note, the absolute next door notes on this piano keyboard represent a semitone or a half step. And so a full step or a tone is just two halves. So half, half, that would be our full step or our full tone. Or alternatively, half, half gives us our full step. For the accidentals, we just need to consider semitones. So we're just considering absolute next door notes on the piano keyboard. You just need to bear that in mind. So now let's go back and we'll return to section J, which is the current chapter that we're on in our workbook. And I have here a piano keyboard. However, I'll just show you quickly on a piece of scrap paper, it's always worth just sketching out for yourself a piano keyboard. It doesn't have to be neat and tidy. There are no marks for artistic ingenuity here. Just give yourself a good octave or so. It's two black notes, miss one. Three black notes, miss one. Two black notes, and so on. So for just a minute's work, you've made your life so much easier. Let's just take all the thinking away from this, and if you just label the keyboard, so we've got C, D, E, F, G, and then A, B, C, D, E. So we've given ourselves a good octave and more. And so this is what it's always going to be referring to. We'll use this lots now over this next few topics. So now we've established what a semitone is, as in the absolute next door notes on the piano keyboard. Of course, that translates to any instrument, but it's just easiest to see it on the piano keyboard. So now let's think about sharps, flats and naturals, which affect the notes that they're written next to. So a sharp, which looks like the hashtag symbol, I assure you the sharp sign was there first. it raises a note by a semitone. So we're just going to raise the note up to the very next semitone. A flat sign lowers a note by a semitone. And a natural sign cancels either of those that have previously occurred. Now, a sharp or a flat or a natural we would refer to generically as an accidental. That's when it's written next to the note that we need it as and when we need it. It lasts for one bar only and only for that given pitch. Other octaves aren't affected. So it only affects that one particular note on that particular pitch, so none of the other octaves are changed, and then the bar line will cancel that. When you're writing these symbols, you've got to think they're written just as precisely as if it was a note. So if the flat sign, or the sharp sign, or the natural sign is on a line, you can see that the line must go through the centre of the symbol. If it's written on a space, you'll notice that it doesn't overlap, but the kind of the box of the symbol is literally within that space and doesn't overlap. You can see it's enclosed in the centre of the symbol. So just be careful when you're placing those. That's why you need a really, really sharp pencil. So either make sure your pencil is super sharp, or use a mechanical pencil to make sure it's always going to be sharp. So let's look at how that affects the notes. Now this is where each note can be given a different name. It just depends upon what's being replaced. And so if we have a C and then sharpen it, we're going to go here. If we have a D and then we flatten it, it's actually the same key, but it's represented on the music differently. C flat, so C lowered a semitone, can also be called B, or B sharp is also referred to as C. So each of these keys can be referred to by different names. It depends upon the context. There's a term for that, and it's referred to as enharmonic. Don't worry about remembering that, just be aware that that term exists. And it's just to show that all of these notes can be referred to by different names. It depends on what line the note is represented, whether it's sharp or flat. Let's look at that in practice here. So first of all, we'll get to grips with these symbols. So be very careful in answering these questions. Use the terminology that I've written here so that you know that you're accurately answering the question. We know that a sharp sign raises a note, but you need to specifically say it raises a note by a semitone. There's no point just saying, oh, it makes a note higher, because that's not specific. We need to say exactly how much higher or exactly how much lower. So have a go at answering those questions. And then you can also have a go at exercise 2 in practicing drawing these symbols. So just press pause, have a go at those, and then when you've had a little go at exercises 1 and 2, re-access into the video and we'll work through that together. So I'm presuming that you've had a little go at that yourself, and so we'll work through this together. So exercise 1, this symbol here is called a sharp, and it raises a note by a semitone. This is called a flat, and it lowers a note by a semitone. Just extend my pencil. It's very specific that we must say that semitone. So this is a natural sign, and this cancels a previous sharp or flat. Because if it's not cancelled by the bar line and the music doesn't require it, we need to cancel it with the natural sound before the bar line would do its job ordinarily. And so let's have a look at drawing these symbols. It does take a bit of practice, and it's just making sure that you position them carefully. The sharp sign is kind of tall and thin, and you make sure that the box falls where the note itself falls. So the box itself encapsulates that space. So now the note is aligned, we need to make sure that the box has the line going through the centre of it. It's quite particular how that's positioned, so it might take a little bit of practice. If you've not quite got it, just rub it out and have another go. It's worth spending a moment just to get that absolutely accurate. The flat sign is a bit like a letter B, but with a pointy base. Again, tall and thin, and you can see that the line goes through the centre of the symbol space there, the B part. Okay, so same principle here. And then when it's a space, you need to make sure that the space occurs where the note does, the note head. Okay, a natural sign. Now this is perhaps a tricky little device to draw. I draw it by thinking of a sort of a oblique L overlapped. Some people find that a little bit too difficult. If you really, really struggle positioning it, some people draw a box and then just put the legs on afterwards. So let's do this box version first, just so you're sure you position it correctly. So we need the box to be where the line is. There we go. And then you can just add the legs on afterwards, if that's the best way of making it accurate. So we would do the same here. The box is the space, and then add the legs on afterwards. If you're feeling a bit more confident about it, you can have your L sort of overlapping over where that line is, and that way you've encapsulated it. I've perhaps gone a little bit too long there. Let's just shorten that a little bit. There we go. Getting carried away. Okay, and so same principle here. The L will be where the space is, and then just overlap to get that shape. Let's have another go. It's irrelevant what the clef is really. We're just drawing the symbol for the moment. Make sure the line is in the centre. If you're finding that not accurate, then just drop back to the drawing your box and then put the legs on afterwards. Draw your box and then put the legs on afterwards. There we go. Just takes a bit of practice, just developing your manuscript skills. Okay, so exercise 3 is going to put into practice a lot of information all in one go. We've got a treble clef here, so we need to remember our treble clef notes. Remember, the lines are represented by every good boy deserves football, and the spaces spell face. So we'll just need to remember that. If you're not sure, just drop back to section D, and those letter names are there. So you could have letter D information sheet to hand just to help you. But now we also need to keep a track on what's going with these accidental signs. So here we've got a G sharp, and so that sharp sign will continue through the whole bar until it's cancelled by the bar line. So actually that note there is still G sharp. However, it's now been cancelled by the bar line, and so here it reverts back to just G. That no longer is in effect, and we're back to normal. So here, I suggest you just have a go at these last two bars, numbers 3, 4, 5, and 6 on your own. Just press pause and then re-access into the video. So I'm assuming that you've had a little go at that, and we'll just finish marking through this together. And so first of all, we know that this is note every good boy, so we need a B to begin with, and then we've got a flat sign, so actually it's a B flat. Notice that when you're writing the letter names and you're naming the notes, we'd say it B flat, as if you were writing it in words, B flat, but when you're writing it in the music, you have to say flat B because we need to know that note's been flattened before we play it. If you're performing this music, there's no point putting the flat afterwards because you'd play that note and it's like, oh, nuts, that should have been flattened. We need to know before we play it, oh, it's a flat B, but we write it in words, B flat. Okie dokie, so carrying on, that is still note B, but this time it's been made natural, so it's a B natural. You can just use the symbol, you don't have to write it in words the whole way. There's certainly not space to do that. Now here, again, we've got every good boy. It's note B. All of these accidentals have now been cancelled, so there's no need to write anything else. It's just plain old B back to as it was before. And then finishing the exercise, the space you spell face, F-A-C-E, so F-A. And if we look before, there's no accidental in place still. Nothing is continuing. So there we go. That's that. So have a go at these last two exercises, B and C. Don't forget to watch out for your clef so you get the correct note names. And then I'll just mark through those with you when you've had a little go. So let's work through these last two exercises together just quickly to get to grips with these sharps, flats and natural signs. So we're in the bass clef now, so it's good boys deserve football, always for the lines, and all cows eat grass for the spaces. So here we are, number one, all cows is C. The sharp hasn't yet come into force, so it's not affected. So here, let's jump ahead. Now we know that it's good boys deserve football always. A is the top line, so B is the next note, and we have a flat, so it's B flat. Now we have all cows, so that's C, and it's been sharpened with that symbol there, so we have a C sharp. Let's jump ahead, so number four, all cows. However, that bar line has cancelled the sharp, so it's no longer in effect, so we're back to normal C. Good boys. Now that is a normal B for many reasons. The flat in the previous bar was a completely different octave, so it wouldn't be affected anyway. And of course, even if it was this top B we were answering, the bar line has cancelled it as well. So here we have good boys, so G, just back to, that's nothing been affected there, just plain old G. Okay, let's finish this last exercise. So this is C. So remember the space you spell face, so that's an F. And now it's an F, but it's been sharpened, so it's F sharp. Number three, every good boy deserves, there's a D. Every good boy, that's a B and it's been flattened. And now let's jump ahead to number five, every good boy. Now that was a B flat, it was cancelled by the natural, however the bar line cancels everything that's gone before, so it's just plain old B again. And then we have face, so we have F, that's it. I hope that's been helpful to you. I've really enjoyed working through that. If you just pop to sharonbill.com, there's everything you need to know there. If you've enjoyed this and it's helped you, give me a thumbs up, give me a like, that'd be fab, and subscribe to this channel, and then you know you're not going to miss out on all the good stuff I've got in store. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.